Welcome. In this video, we will be doing a walkthrough showing the setup in the SQL Server AlwaysOn template in the Azure Preview Portal, which can be found at portal.azure.com. This template automatically configures for you an AlwaysOn availability group with a listener configured to point to the current primary and everything else that needs to be configured for an availability group. You get the SQL Server primary and secondary. And the secondary is configured as readable by default so that you can offload read workloads. Domain controller primary and secondary so your domain doesn't have a single point of failure. The failover cluster, the virtual network, everything is configured for you. The great thing about this is it takes about a minute for you to configure this in the portal and then it's deployed for you in the background. Currently, doing this manual setup takes about 5 to 6 hours, maybe, if you're fairly new to the process. And if you're fairly experienced with it, it'll take maybe 2 hours of manually configuring step-by-step this whole AlwaysOn availability group. All you have to do is you go into the preview portal and you enter in the configuration that you want. You can click on new, or you can configure a new thing, and you see it right here. You can also go to the marketplace. It can be found in everything or in virtual machines, and you go down to SQL Server, where you can find all the images related to SQL Server. Then we scroll down, and you see right there, again, is the SQL Server 2014 AlwaysOn template. And then opens up the description of this feature, shows you, as I described, everything that you get. And then you also see links to pricing information, documentation, and the forum. Here, if you have any questions or need any help, okay, and then we go ahead and click create, and we see all you have to enter is the resource group name, the username, and password. Everything else is optional if you want to customize your setup. So if we go ahead and enter the resource group name, and so now that we've entered that, all you'd have to do is click create, and you're done. It took less than a minute. But if you want to customize your setting, you can go to these additional options. We'll take a look at SQL Server settings first. As you see, everything is auto-generated based on the resource group name, as I said. The SQL Server VM names, the availability group name, the listener name are all auto-generated based on the resource group. When we look down at additional settings, you see the listener is enabled by default. In addition, there's the default size of the VM is standard A5, but that can be changed. You see the size of the file share witness is basic A0, which cannot be changed. And then the SQL Server service account is generated based on the username and password. Also generated by the username and password that you enter is the domain sysadmin account and the local SQL admin account. But you have the option of changing the SQL Server service account if you do not wish for it to be the same as your domain account and your local SQL admin account. So go ahead and click OK because all these settings look all right, and we'll take a look at the additional configurations. Now, if we go ahead and look at the domain settings, we'll see that that is also auto-generated for you, but you can change that if you wish, just like everything else. So we're happy with those settings. We'll look at virtual network. And we see the virtual network is also auto-generated, and we're happy with that. The storage account, the default is that a new storage account will be created, but you can also select from an existing storage account. So say we're happy with all of these settings. Now the only thing left to select is the subscription account that we would like to use and the location where we would like these VMs to be provisioned. And then we can just click create and then we're completely done. So even if you go through and customize everything, it takes maybe a couple minutes as opposed to a couple hours. So while this is deploying in the background, you can go about your other business, but let's take a look. And I'll show you what we see in the resource group that we have just created. Resource groups is a new technology introduced in the new Azure portal. It groups together a group of resources that share a lifecycle. So for something like this AlwaysOn template, it has all of the 5 VMs created for you, your domain names, your virtual network, and your storage account. Everything is there. And you can also see additional information like the events, the past week that have taken place for your resource group. Currently, it's all the provisioning events. You can also see alerts, billing information, everything once it is complete provisioning. And that is all. Thank you for watching this video. And if you have any questions or feedback to give, please post in the forums. The link will be in the description below.